started, and this ought to be a good one, between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the New York Jets. With that, we head up to MetLife Stadium as we'll hand it over to the two men that'll call the action, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Coach, we have a damp and rainy afternoon in the tri-state area as EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to MetLife Stadium in the Garden State of New Jersey. A few minutes ago, the hometown Jets were introduced to this sellout crowd, and it's a roar that could be heard across the river in Manhattan. They're set to go as their Jets will match up with Ben Roethlisberger and the Pittsburgh Steelers. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gauden. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
On to get us started now, the kicker, Chris Boswell. And this one is underway here on EA Sports. This is fielded at the goal line. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
We got this.
So now here comes the Jet offense as they get ready to take over. And we get a glance here at their leader, the man who will be calling the plays under center.
And what I'm looking for from him today, the things every quarterback is looking to do. Lead his team to a victory. Doesn't matter whether he's throwing it, running it, handing it off, however he has to do it, as well as exhibiting some leadership, that's what he's trying to accomplish.
Ready to break.
Mike 55, Mike 55. I got you.
Get it.
On play action, they'll throw. Throw complete to Herndon.
Holding offense.
So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. Now Bell. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first.
I know that play went to the left side, and that's what it was designed to do, an outside handoff there. But how about the whole offensive line being involved? Seal the left side where the play was going, what they call play side. But how about on the back side? Just taking care of business to make sure no one can get there and disrupt it.
Is the biggest key the left tackle?
Without a doubt. Control that edge. Get out there. You want that left tackle, or if you bring your tight end over there, either way, control the edge of the line of scrimmage, you got a chance to rumble.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Robbie Anderson, the man he was looking for. And that'll bring up second down.
Ready, set.
98, watch 98. 98 to Mike. Here we go again.
Second and 10. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down. And the starting defensive unit here for Pittsburgh.
Bud Dupree came out of the University of Kentucky determined to let everyone know that they play football there as well as basketball. A terrific pass rusher off the edge.
So now third and 10, they had the big play to start the drive, but two incompletions since.
Ready.
They're going to look to throw. And he's taken to the ground, but he was pulled down by the face mask. Here come the flags, and I believe this is going to be a first down. Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
Now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. After the penalty, it's Bell. And he'll get this one across midfield and down into Steeler territory. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Come on, 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple.
That's trash.
Back.
Take river.
Out of the shotgun, it's Bell. And an alley to run. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. That one good for 26 and a first down. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Le'Veon Bell there to make the grab. And the Jets take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Well, he wasn't the guy they were initially going for, but after going through the progressions, it worked.
When you have plenty of people who can catch the football, you don't always have to go to your primary target, and sometimes that target is actually covered. Nice job coming off of that and getting it to someone who was open.
Yeah, the man out of the backfield gets in for the score. Now for the point after. Footing likely going to be an issue all night here on a rainy night, but this one is good. That drive goes 80 yards in 6 plays, and it ends with a Jet touchdown. Here's Sam Ficken now for the Jet field goal. This will be taken very short. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. So the Steelers offense getting set for their first drive. They'll be led out by Big Ben, their veteran quarterback, Ben Roethlisberger.
He's one of the more exalted quarterbacks in the league, but I still don't think he gets enough appreciation for his ability to read defenses and lead his ball club.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll run with the NC State man. It's Jalen Samuels. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Brings up second and 4 at the 39-yard line.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. Play fake to Connor. Now Roethlisberger under a heavy rush, and down he goes. C.J. Mosley, the linebacker, making sure his presence is felt.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
So the sack, and now a third and long situation for the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
On fourth down, here comes a Steeler punter, Jordan Berry, to kick it away. A big kick, 50 yards that time, with a return of four. And the Jets will take over first and 10. The New York set to take the field. And certainly they'll be hoping to hit pay dirt like they did on the last drive. Got the football back, so a chance to go up two scores.
And they haven't been tentative at all in this ball game, because sometimes you start a game with your script to try and get information out of the opposing defense. How will they play you in certain situations? Sometimes you script to attack, and that's what I'm seeing so far.
Ready, ready. 50, plant.
They'll start out on the ground with Bell. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. One thing's for sure, this defense has to figure out how to stop the ground game. He's eating them up here in the first quarter.
It looks like they have to go to different forces, aren't they? The conventional things aren't working too well. So I remember a coach of mine saying way back when a back's having a great game, you've got to get the ball out of his hands. See how far he can run without the ball. And what he meant was takeaways, knock it loose, because maybe you can't just stop him with just regular tackling.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. 14 yards is the pickup there at a Jet first down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks, because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going
to ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did. The goal for any offense versus his own defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route.
Ready.
Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 39-yard line.
Get up.
They'll run it with Bell. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage.
Let's go now. 60 Pittsburgh.
55 to Mike.
I'm coming.
On second down, it's Bell. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
It's a gain of six. Brings up third and six.
Here we go. 60 yards.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Steelers nothing.
They need to get to the 29 if they want to pick up a first here on third down. They'll look to throw here. He's going to air one out for Anderson, and that'll be incomplete. Well, they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty, and it's fourth down. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
Darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
So on fourth down, the Jets turn to kicker Sam Ficken. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. And this kick is not going to be close. It's well short, well right to boot. And this score will stay right where it is.
Now, if this was a clear day in September, I'd say this is well within his range. I'd feel very confident about this kick. But let's be honest about it. In these elements, the difficulty level gets ratcheted up by at least a factor of five.
Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. It hasn't gone particularly well for them, that's obvious. In these conditions, no points so far. They've got to get that offense on track. The question, how do they do it?
It is the age-old question, isn't it? And to me, finding a way to make sure your playmakers touch the ball without it being too exotic. Meaning you don't have to go deep down the field. Maybe you hit them on those short passes on the perimeter. Make sure you just turn around and hand it to your best runner and get out of the way. Don't cause any extra stress on your offense.
Now a pass that's taken in by Smith-Schuster. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. They went three and out on their first drive. Things already looking better here, first and 10. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
That, black 20.
Night, night, sweetheart.
On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism. Great hand-eye coordination. Guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Roethlisberger going to get this one to Connor. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, a ball may come your way.
That! White 80!
Right there, 54 Mike.
First carry for James Conner. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second down, Conner looking for space. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. Chalk that up as a 4-yard loss. And now it's third down. Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage, because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, because they bring in your tight end, keep him in, your running backs, they have to step forward. Bottom line, your offensive line has to block them first to give yourself a chance.
On third down, Roethlisberger. And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line. Henry Anderson coming in to drop it for a loss of 8. And it also brings up fourth.
Well, how about that? A dime set on defense, 6 defensive backs. None of them blitz. They're just back there in coverage. defensive lineman gets the sack.
That's where the O-line, they go to the sideline, they keep their helmets on so the cameras can't find them, right?
Yeah, the cameras can't find them, but I know one thing, the O-line coach will.
So on fourth down, the Steelers call on the number of Chris Boswell for the field goal try. It'll be spotted on the right hash, a 52-yard attempt. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short, no good. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. Back to throw here. He throws and he hits the slant route to Thomas. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Set, 70, Indy. We ain't giving up nothing to
Jets. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. A screen to Bell. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid gain.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Second and 5. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
I think that's a big time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. But able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football, that's why he was able to bat it away.
They come up now third and 5 following the incomplete pass. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And that's incomplete. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for 3, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. This will be spotted just shy of midfield, a 59-yard attempt.
Let's go. Let's do it.
And that's the risk of the long field goal miss here at this stage of the second quarter. You give up great field position.
And that gives them one more opportunity to make something happen and something big. And we've seen crazy stuff happen at the end of halves.
And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
So good field position for the Steelers as they come up first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 49. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson. Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts.
as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. Now it's Roethlisberger. Incomplete. Brian Poole that time there to get a hand on it.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. You ain't doing nothing today. From the gun on third down, it's Roethlisberger. That'll be taken in there by James Washington. Now the Steelers use the second of their three timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime.
All right, now.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Throwing again, it's Roethlisberger. Johnson's got it complete. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you got to run fast. Of course, you got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness, there's a premium for all of that now.
Throwing again on second down, Roethlisberger. He released that awkwardly. It almost looked like a pitcher who gripped his fastball a little too hard and let it go late and it bounced in front of the plate.
Yeah, one of those fastballs that ends up at 57 feet, not 60 feet, 6 inches. Just a little short with the arm, which is unusual because we saw him in warm-ups. He's got a big, strong arm when he delivers it with confidence.
Now Roethlisberger. Open man, Smith-Schuster, it's complete. And shedding the tackle, and now some room. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Juju Smith-Schuster as the first half is winding down. As they are now on the board here in the first half. Chris Boswell now for the extra point. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So the drive there took 6 plays, and it ends with the Steelers finding the end zone. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And a very good return, but a penalty marker is down. I'm not sure what this is going to be.
Defense.
So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
Come
The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. They'll drop the throw. Incomplete. And we're down to 8 seconds now. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. They'll look to throw. Found his target. It's Anderson. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. So a touchdown apiece. That's what we have to show at halftime as they head to the locker room. 7-7 our score. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. This will be taken in at the 1. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter 3.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. Ready? Big Ben and the Steelers with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19. Well, that tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point. They continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10.
Let's go, let's bring it, let's bring it.
On first and 10 is Connor. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard, there was no room to run. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run.
Come to my work. We want it.
On second down, Samuels.
And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a third and nine situation. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. He'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Here's Jordan Berry now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. He'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline. So here's the Jets offense now as they get ready for their first possession of the second half. Their defense did its job, yielded no points. Now it's the offense's turn.
And how much fun is that when you set things up to start a half and you just tell you guys, hey, if you can shut them down, get it back for our offense, we can roll. And they played out perfectly. Now, can the offense do what they wanted to do at the half, which is find those weaknesses and now attack them and score some points.
And break this tie.
Get it.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down. So, Charles, tie game here. What are your keys as we continue to play this second half?
I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better? In this case, to me, it's turnovers. You've got to take care of the football in order to win the game.
Now a pass taken in by the tight end Herndon, and they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. That catch good for five. It's third down.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
The last play on the completion got him half of what they needed. Now here's a tough third and five. Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
Here's Lachlan Edwards now, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. This will be fielded at the 17. Now a late flag comes in as they got him down via the face mask, and that'll give him even better starting position. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. They go draw play. This is Samuels. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. A gain of 10. Good for a Steeler first down.
At this stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack, because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that, because the defense might be a little bit off balance. And they pick up another first down with that run.
Like 80.
They're running it.
Lock it back.
They'll run again with Samuels on first down. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Play fake to Connor. Now Roethlisberger. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a 3rd down. How about the defensive effort from both of these teams that we've seen in this game?
Would you say it's like a high-stakes chess match right now?
Chess is one way to go.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I like it.
Okay, the only reason I say that, you feel like they're contemplating their moves before actually making one, and none of them being done very confidently.
Truth be told, I've never played chess, and I know that I'm not smart enough to play chess. Guys like you with your IQ, you can pull that off.
That one good for 24 yards.
You know, when I see passes like that, I'm reminded of something you and I talked about yesterday. Big Ben was a wide receiver the first 3 years of high school, sitting behind the coach's son, and then he finally got that opportunity. I think he's made the most of it.
It's always the coach's son, isn't it? But you know where it helps him? When he looks downfield, he knows what the receivers are going to do. He actually has wide receiver's eyes when he's throwing the ball.
On 1st down, it's Connor. And a pickup of about 4 down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. They'll stay on the ground with Connor again. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that's going to bring up a 3rd down. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his 3rd down play as we've played 3 quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Steelers on 3rd down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is 3rd and 9. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Open man completes it to Smith-Schuster. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a 4th down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield.
So here we go. On now is the kicker, Chris Boswell. This to break our 4th quarter tie. And Boswell's kick is 7.
So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
After the successful field goal try, here's Boswell to send it away. This fielded at the 2. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line.
Now the Jets offense about set to take over as they head onto the field. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
All right. Here we go. Let's go.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
Following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17.
Ready.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Herndon's got it complete. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
Now a draw play. This is Bell. And he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the first down marker. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll bring up a fourth down.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Here's Lachlan Edwards now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Fair catch called for and made at the 16 or maybe the 17-yard line. Yeah, call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. A little less than 4 minutes remaining, and the margin for error is small with this slim lead. Operate within your 4-minute offense here, Charles?
Definitely. And remember, the 4-minute offense doesn't always correspond to what's up on the clock. What they need to do is play a little bit of keep away right now. Run the clock down. Make sure their opponent doesn't get the ball back. Their dream scenario, get enough first downs and make them eat up their timeouts so the game ends when you're kneeling down with the football.
Oh, he breaks a tackle and he's got an alley. Pittsburgh getting 16 yards there and also a first down.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation when they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously. But at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Roethlisberger will throw. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. Looked like he had a couple of different options as far as who to throw to on that play. And who am I to say this, but I'm not sure he made the right decision.
Well, the window of opportunity is always going to be small in the NFL. That's why those quarterbacks who make quick decisions and have quick releases have the most success in this league.
On second down now, Samuels. And once again, not much running room, if any at all. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. A good pick up there, 26 yards. Big hook up there, forced to throw it on third down. The connection's going to keep the drive alive and also keep the clock moving.
Yeah, and from a defensive perspective, didn't get a sack, didn't knock the ball free, didn't break up the pass. The clock keeps running on you. You're in a dire situation now.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. They'll run on first down. Connor, and some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. So fresh out of the 2 minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Again, it's Connor. He'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left.
Here we go. Like 80.
54 miles. I can't believe they let you play.
He'll try and run for it with Connor. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38.
You got it.
The Jets going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And this one will not get there. It's off to the left anyway. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. Maybe an important fourth quarter miss as this stays a 3-point game.
Yeah, now overtime is very much in the equation here. Just what you mentioned, a 3-point game. They get a drive, put it through the posts. We could have some free football, couldn't we?
So the Jets now down by a field goal, just over a minute 40 to play. They need at minimum 3 points out of this as they come up first and 10. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 45. He's back to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Steelers. The big man, get the oxygen tank ready. And this defense has broken it open as they return it to the house for 6. This was a close game. They needed a little breathing room. Boy, they got it right there on that return for a touchdown.
Yeah, we would say that this could be huge. Forget it. It was huge. Gave them a comfortable lead.
Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. It's good to make it 17-7. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for six. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. This fielded at the two. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. A chance for us again to look at this Pittsburgh defense. They're looking for one final stop here, put this game on ice. What's the message from the defensive coordinator here?
Don't overthink it. You know what you have to do. Let's get this game over with and get to the locker room.
Yeah, that's the key, right? Just get it over quickly. They don't want to deal with any extra time.
You don't want any extra time. You don't want to do something out of the ordinary that gives them an opportunity and hope. Go out there and play the way you know how.
On the ready.
Watch the backer. They'll come out throwing here on first down. He's got Herndon, his tight end. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially. First down now, but that clock rolling. He'll drop to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Bud Dupree in there to take him down, and the clock will roll.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And it's a rush to the line right now for the Jets. Come off the ball. He'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. That's caught inside the 20. And he takes it down deep into Pittsburgh territory. Big yardage that time for the Jets. 41 yards. So after the big play, look at this. All the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And this is going to be caught. So it affects the final score, not the outcome, but it is a late touchdown here on the game's final play. Doesn't affect the outcome, but hey, nice job there to put it in the end zone for the final play.
Could it affect other things? Sometimes these types of scores are ones that we don't consider big at the time. Then later on we find out maybe that was a tiebreaker.
Yeah.
Or, of course, in the fantasy football world, these points mean a lot.
A lot there. The extra point here is good, but the late touchdown can only draw the score a bit closer as this game is over. Well, on the one side, if you try to take away something positive from this game, they played to the final whistle, getting the touchdown there on the last play, but still, all for naught, really.
Yeah, I'd say give them points for positivity. I like that. That part is good. But I often wonder, when the game is settled and the clock has run out, do we really need to kick the extra point?
Oh, yeah. It's silly.
It doesn't make any sense to me. I know that people have explained before, well, you got to play it all the way through. Come on, this thing was done.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. Good night, everybody.